Beginning Proofs, Level 1. In the following series of videos, we will learn how to write simple two-column proofs. The two-column proof, also known as a statement reason proof, is the main type of proof that we will use as we continue learning the concepts in geometry. Traditionally, students do not encounter formal proofs until they take this geometry course. In reality, if you solved an equation in a beginning algebra course and have justified steps in those solutions, then you already have the experience necessary to create and present mathematical proofs. A proof is a convincing mathematical argument. This means that any person who understands the terminology, accepts the definitions and premises of the mathematics involved, and thinks in a logically correct fashion, cannot deny the validity of the conclusions drawn. When describing the solution of an equation as an algebraic proof, the premises for the proof are the given equation, the properties of equality, and the properties of real numbers. These premises may be used as justifications for each step in the solution of an equation. The process is analogous to the process used when writing geometric proofs. An algebraic proof uses algebraic properties of equality. Recall from your beginning algebra course that the properties of equality include the addition property of equality, subtraction property of equality, multiplication property of equality, division property of equality, reflexive property of equality, symmetric property of equality, transitive property of equality, and substitution property of equality. An algebraic proof also uses the distributive property. An important part of writing a proof involves the justification of every step. For example, say that we want to solve the following equation, and we are asked to prove it. We start our two-column proof by writing the equation on the left column as follows. We will write all of our statements on the left column, creating a new line for each statement. On the right column, we will write out our reasons or justifications of the statements from the left column. Each statement must be numbered and correspond to a reason, which has the same number as a statement in the left column. Each numbered statement and reason must originate on the same line. Usually, the first statements in a proof will be given to you. In this case, we are given this equation, so the justification or reason for this statement will be given equation. Next, we proceed in solving the equation. So we first apply the distributive property and distribute 2 into each term. We then write the reason or justification for this step. In this case, we write distributive property, since we applied the distributive property to obtain the new statement. Next, we subtract 2 from both sides of the equation and simplify. Now, this is where many students make a very common mistake. Many students would write subtracted 2 from both sides as a reason or justification. This would be an incorrect reason. The correct reason needs to make use of the properties of equality. In this case, we use the subtraction property of equality. The justification for each step is not simply a description of the operation, but rather a general mathematical principle. So make sure you use a mathematical principle as a justification. The last step is to divide both sides of the equation by 6. Doing that, we obtain x equals 5. For our justification, we write division property of equality and not divide by 6. Like algebra, geometry also uses numbers, variables, and operations. For example, segment lengths and angle measures are numbers. So you can use these same properties of equality to write algebraic proofs in geometry. We will begin to formalize the study of geometry by going over very basic proofs and then add subsequent layers of complexity as we continue with our studies of geometry. The geometry concepts presented in these videos are largely based on the ideas set forth more than 2,000 years ago by the Greek mathematician Euclid. His series of books, Elements, is the first known work in which a logical, deductive system of reasoning is used as a means of unifying all mathematical knowledge. In that spirit, geometric proofs will help us learn how to build a logically coherent system of facts by using deductive reasoning. Geometry is based on an axiomatic system. A modern axiomatic system begins with a small set of undefined terms and builds through the addition of definitions and postulates to the point where many rich mathematical theorems can be proved. In an axiomatic system, we agree to leave some terms undefined and then build definitions of other terms and postulates from those undefined terms. Undefined terms can be described but cannot be given precise definitions using simple known terms. Three undefined terms in geometry are point, line, and plane. Recall that a point is a circular dot that is shrunk until it has no size. A line is formed by an infinite number of points. It also has an infinite length, so we denote this idea by using arrowheads. Also, a line has no thickness. A plane is a sheet of paper formed by an infinite number of points with no thickness and extending infinitely in all directions. Although a plane has no edges, we usually picture a plane by drawing a four-sided figure. We often label a plane with a capital letter. These descriptions provide a way for us to visualize points, lines, and planes, but they are not definitions. We define space to be the set of all points. Any collection of points is called a geometric figure. In particular, lines and planes are composed of points and hence are geometric figures. Postulates are statements that we assume to be true. Postulates state relationships among defined and undefined terms. The purpose of stating postulates is to establish some first principles upon which the subject of geometry is based. After introducing postulates and some definitions, we may deduce new results. Results that we deduce from undefined terms, definitions, postulates, or results that follow from them are commonly called theorems. A theorem is a mathematical statement that can be proved. Geometric proofs provide the logical structure that supports an increasingly complex and powerful set of theorems. In a general geometric proof, the premises are definitions, postulates, properties, and previously proven theorems. The early theorems in these videos may seem trivial, and writing proofs for such apparently obvious statements can seem strange at first, but it is important to understand that these theorems will be needed for later work. The goal of this and subsequent videos is to provide an opportunity so you can become familiar with the key elements of a proof. These proofs will become more complex as we continue with our studies of geometry. When writing a geometric proof, you use deductive reasoning to create a chain of logical steps that move from the hypothesis to the conclusion of the conjecture you are proving. By proving that the conclusion is true, you have proven that the original conjecture is true. When writing a proof, it is important to justify each logical step with a reason. You can use symbols and abbreviations, but they must be clear enough so that anyone who reads your proof will understand them. A geometric proof begins with given and proof statements, which restate the hypothesis and conclusion of the conjecture respectively. In a two-column proof, you list the steps of the proof in the left column. You then write the matching reason for each step in the right column. Before you start writing a proof, you should plan out your logic. If a diagram for a proof is not provided, draw your own and mark the given information on it. But do not mark the information in the proof statement on the diagram, since this is what we are trying to prove. All right, in our next video, we will present and prove our first two theorems in geometry.